Ladies and gentlemen, let me, take a minute to explain or introduce Lucy and Clements. Both of them are with Mattel Borto, and they're really, both of them are super passionate about helping students. Clements has been in the higher education industry for the last 4 years, and she is currently the International Recruitment Manager at Mattel Borto. Lucy is currently the International Recruitment Director at Mattel Borto, right? And something, if I can just quote something from, something that she wrote in her own words, she says, "Higher education is not just a mere product. And as a student, you should actually seek goals, goals that make you bloom as a professional and help you grow as a human being." And, she has actually traveled the world extensively. And that's what, it motivated her to guide foreign students to find their path, right? And there's nothing better than learning when you're traveling the world. So the session that we have here today, Wine and Spirits Career Opportunities. And at this point, I'll go back to Lucy. And
Yeah, I'm so sorry. We were having some technical issues, so I'm so sorry for the echo and for everything. I'm back.
all right, fantastic. And we can hear you clearly.
Yes.
So what I'm going to do is I'm going to shift myself back to a presenter. I'll exit this video call, and if you like, you can invite your colleague Clements to join you
I'm
here.
just, how do you invite someone?
Next to Clements, let me invite her for you. Okay.
Okay, perfect. Thank you very much. I'm
All
sorry,
right.
guys, if you were actually waiting for me. Now the technical problem are resolved. I will be able to join the presentation. And this is Clémence, so this is my colleague, and we will be able to talk to you about the wine and spirit career opportunities. Some of us was already on our booth, so you were able to ask us some questions. And so now this is, I know that it's for the MBA program, but it will be something a little bit more, let's say, now I cannot share my, I cannot go to my screen, so this is perfect.
It really teaches us, flexibility, adaptation, so all the qualities you need to have right now, actually, in any professional world.
And you see, you need to keep
Yeah.
smiling. So that's the hospitality industry. So just a quick presentation of the group. So Vatel, it's 50 campuses around the world. We're having something like 36,000 of alumni, and we are the largest group, the first one in France. And we're representing Clémence and myself, Vatel Bordeaux, which welcome international students with studies in English. So this is for the quick introduction that we can have. So the wine and spirit industry and all the opportunities that you can have. First, let's talk about the wine in France. So you see this year, even with the COVID, so we're hearing a lot of things because of the wine industry can be a little difficult right now. But in terms of the quality of the wine this year, it's impressive. Because there is already 35 million hectolitres, so plus 6% compared to last year. And because of the weather, because we were having a lot of heat wave, so it will be a very, very nice year for the French wine. So very happy, not just for Bordeaux, but for all the wines. So it is something that we are very, very strong about, and it will be nice. Now, if you're talking about the wine, something that's a little bit different that in India, we are a lot of innovation. You know, Bordeaux, it's from Rome Antique. So basically, it's an institution. It's the roots of all the wine. So if you're talking about California wine, if you're talking about Australian wine, most of the roots are coming from Bordeaux. So in a way, why go elsewhere when you can come to France and directly to Vatel Bordeaux to learn about the wine industry? In terms of innovation, there is something who was coming up for the next five, for the last 5 years. It's wine in cans. If me, I'm gonna say, oh, what shocker! Because how can you drink a wine elsewhere than in a bottle? It's for emerging market like in India. Cans can be very nice. Instead of opening a Coca-Cola can, you will have wine. You have also something who's trendy in the US. It's the wine with all alcohol. It's something also that we're working on in France. It's about organic wine without pesticide, or some harvesting the old-fashioned way, meaning with a horse and without using petrol and only with using human skills. Now you want to go, Clémence?
Yes, so basically, the India, it's true that you don't You don't drink really a lot of wine, and the making of wine has started roughly around 30 years ago in regions like around in Maharashtra, for instance, also around Bangalore.
Mumbai.
Maharashtra, that's what I was saying, but also in Bangalore, in China, you have wine as well. And in Nashik, around Pune, also. So basically, it's quite recent. And most of the time, well, you don't really drink wine. It's more about beer and more about wine and about spirits, whiskey, for instance, all the good old brandy. The idea for you is to, I mean, and for us, obviously, as foreigners and as people working in Bordeaux, which is basically the worldwide capital of wine, we see India as a very interesting market. But what is really cool to know is actually wine has been booming in the recent years, and even during lockdown, it has been booming as well because there are a lot of things which have evolved, like delivery, like and obviously also the wine tourism, especially in Maharashtra, for instance, but not only. You have very nice rooftop, for instance, in Bangalore or in Delhi. So it's actually cool to know that there's something there to be done for you. In terms of the wine that Indian people drink at the moment, it could be mostly red, that's for certain. And well, surprisingly, it's mostly from Australia first. I disagree with that personally, but that's the numbers. And the EU. And on the top of that, obviously, France and Italy are very important countries importing wine in India.
What is important also, we are putting Singapore, why? Because lately, to be able, because of the importation tax, who are very huge. Here we are talking about 150 to 170%. Because remember, if we are talking about 1 euro bottle of wine from France coming to Bordeaux, for example, who will be something like cheap wine for us at 1 euro, it will come on the Indian table at something that more than 20 euros, so almost 2,000 2,000 rupee. So you see the amount of taxes, margins, and everything. So this is something who may change, but right now this is happening. But still, it's very good because at some point we see that the market for that India is representing as a blooming, very huge, important one. And what we were saying, and Clémence was saying, the way that India is right now is saying the wine, it's through what she's able to taste. And we are lucky because French wine are very trendy in India, but as well as Australian, South African one. The wine is mostly urban. And now it's becoming much more fashionable for women to have a glass of wine. So this is something important. For the local international market, also the Sula wine and the other brand are being recognized much more than before. So it's something that means that India has a place to has a place to play on the international scales. Clémence was saying about the new trend, especially wine tourism, wine association, and WSET, who are exploding because of the COVID situation. So it's been good. It's mean that in Asia, and especially Nepal and India, people are starting to be interested in those paths. And if you are in front of us today, it's mean that you are interested also to know learn about the career, not just into sommelier, but the career that you can have inside of this industry.
Just for you to imagine what you can do if you turn just 1% of all the beer drinkers into people who enjoy drinking wine. It's just huge, and we don't, from a European perspective, we don't have this kind of market here anymore. So it's important for you to know and to understand what kind of perspective you have if you choose to work in this industry in India.
And we were having the question inside of our booth, why India and what can be done in India. So here, Clémence will tell you about the career that we can talk about. Because again, if you're talking hospitality is not about services, there is a lot of opportunity and a lot of career. We will tell them about later also. But the wine is the same. You're not only here to learn about become a sommelier. You have other perspective. And remember, as Indian, on the international scale, India especially since the COVID, is attracting a lot of views. People are talking more and more about India. You are the place to be, the market to be. So as Indian students inside of the wine, if you're learning a little bit of French, I will say that it's jackpot. It's a very bonus. Why? Because all those castles, all those companies, the luxury company, will be interesting to have an Indian partner to come and to be represented in India. So the fact that you're Indian, the fact that you're speaking English is, for me, the best thing, the best card you have to play. Now, let's talk about the career.
Mm-hmm. So there are tons of things that you can do in the in this industry. Basically, you take any business-related area, and any business related jobs, and you have it in this industry as well. So we have more specific positions like F&B manager, sommelier, mixologist. So this is really typically related to the wine. And then you will have the other positions which are more related to business. So entrepreneur, you can choose to open your own rooftop, your own wine, your own wine shop, your own cafe. I mean, we know that supply chain and import-export are very important in India. So that's exactly a field that you can do, because wine and spirit, they require a special packaging, for instance. They require, say, special areas to be kept in. And at the moment, there are not really a lot of things available for wine business in this environment. Same thing if you want to really focus on something which is going to be more related to tourism. We've already mentioned the areas around Mumbai, Nashik, Pune, Bangalore, Chennai. So you have like a few spots like this which are amazing if you want to go on a weekend. Away from the big cities, you just go there, you change air, you drink wine, you have nice food, and it's actually something really cool to do if you want, I don't know, to prepare a wedding or something like this. It's really, really cool place to just spend a weekend to relax. And wine tourism is actually growing more and more. When it was previously just, you know, some like weird people going to taste wine, actually it's especially for the young ones, it's starting to be very trendy. Same thing if you want to work more in the marketing side of things, because I know we have a lot of students interested in marketing. Well, that's completely possible as well. If you couple that to some data and stuff, that's actually a very interesting mix for you, because you can understand how to use the social media, how to use the data in order to promote your brand. And there are tons of careers you can imagine in this field, actually. And if there's not the career that you want, if it's not the career that you want, you know, if you're not interested in what is listed here, well, you can just invent it. And it's the perfect, I mean, the hospitality industry and the wine sector are actually perfect to do so. Because you're just, I mean, there are so many things that you can do, and a lot of jobs have not even been invented. So yeah, you can move on.
Yeah. since we are a little late, I will go very fast on why coming to France, because we already discussed that in the booth, but it's also important. And after that, we will have all the career from the hospitality industry that you may want to go and discover. So why France? Why coming to France? As we say earlier, France is known especially for the gastronomy, hospitality, wine and spirit, and the luxury industry. Also, right now for the startup and everything related to the alumni. When you're a French one, it's good, especially as you have some very nice stay back. So it's 1 + 1, 2 years of stay back when you're doing a master or MBA in France, and you will be able to travel to France. You will be able to do some business with friends easily. And of course, for the one who wants to stay back and find a job. So a lot of questions about work permit. Work permit, it's after you get a position in France. And in this case, you have to find a company who will employ you. But India, as we say, is very sick of by the company. So you have a very nice class to play by coming to France. The scholarship, it was a quick one. So we talked previously also about the scholarship. If you want to come to France, there are 4 of them. You go on the Campus France website and you will be able to see the Opera one. So the Bandman Chamandari is actually one who specializes in culinary art and hospitality. The Eiffel and the Sharpac are the one who are mostly applied by all the Indian students who wants to come to France. The last one, Ama Adalmia, is actually for women. So if you are a woman, think also that coming to France can be a good opportunity. Now, Bordeaux, as you may see, it's just some quick picture of the city because we have a world heritage. We are a world city heritage, especially the city center. And after that, modern. The difference with India is we are walking a lot and we are close to the vineyard and to also to the sea. So it's a mix of modernity and history. Close to as a Schengen, we are very close to London, to
all the main European capitals.
Yes. So it's a very good position. Now, study Angvatel. So go ahead, Clémence, if you want to.
I want to. To study at Vatel, basically, for this year, and we know it's a bit specific and it's a bit special. So we have put, all our students are back on campus. They will be back soon until November. Basically, for those who cannot be there yet because of their visa problem or anything, we have put together some online options. So they will all follow their classes and they will not lack any classes and any subjects, and at the same time, we have also equipped the campus with a lot of connectivity and like big screens, and which will be used for us to do workshops, to do webinars, and any extracurricular activities with the students, because we've been aware during the lockdown period that it was important for us to offer not only classes but obviously other activities which will make us able to keep the bond together and to also offer new options for the students to study, not only in physical presence in the school. For the bachelor, I've seen that there was a question about the bachelor in the discussion. The program is 3 years, 3 years long. During the first year, you explore. During the second year, you confirm what you've already seen, and during the third year, you really get to go into a bit of specialization. What is specific about Vatel is that you will have always during the 2 weeks of class and 2 weeks of practical training, and at the end of the years, you will have an internship every time. So it's really focusing on practice. It's really helping you to become actual professional. So that is what our objective is during the bachelor. What you will study, it will be a mix of business, so focusing on marketing, HR and accounting, and a mix of really specific course related to hospitality. So why? Because, you know, it's basically in our DNA, and everything related to nutrition, taxation, and self-image also. So it's really a mix of business and specific classes related to hospitality. So if you want to become a manager, it's the bachelor that you need to do. And what is really, really important for us is that you will take the initiative from day one.
The MBA, so because we were here to talk about the MBA, especially the specialization, so we are not just having the MBA in wine, you also have a normal MBA in hospitality management. Yeah. So again, 18-month program, 6 months of professional training, and a recognition. So here it's okay. What you will learn, basically, compared to the bachelor who was very operational, here in 18 months, you will go into the strategical aspect. Here you want to open an entrepreneur, you want to manage people, you want to be able to know if your business will be successful. Basically, you will ask yourself a lot of questions and try to be proactive, take responsibility, not just to follow. And something which is very important, especially right now, you are the new generation who will be able to invent, to create, and to have some innovation in the new way of thinking the hospitality. So this is very important time for you to be able to develop your thinking capacity. The wine and spirit, so you were saying, so there is a lot of on-site visit and a lot of testing, plus every related classes to everything on business. You will pass also level 2 and level 3 of the WSET. who's the UK certification for the sommelier. And people are asking why come to Vatel Bordeaux for this specialization, for our ability, because the class are very small. We are 20 to 25 people by classes. And for the fact that before graduation, we have 100% of placement of the students before the graduation. So we are very, very proud of that. And the fact that usually the rate of success to the WSET level 3, it's 32%, and we have something who's close to 75%. So it's a very, very good one. Again, you're coming for the network. So in 26 years of experience here, into the vineyard, into the big castle. So you're coming also because of the network and because of the advantage that you can come inside of this industry. Clémence was saying that you will have also wine into the bachelor, but mostly it's going to be something more serious into the MBA program. Now, the new career path. So here that was the wine industry, but think of the COVID as something who has changed the future of the hospitality. You need to, the world has changed, the hospitality has changed, and that's the way that it should be. Think of artificial, high-tech automatization. Why? Because of the penibility of the work. For example, cleaning the swimming pool can be done by robots, but also because of the COVID. So now you need to think, should I have some tablecloth? Should I use salt and pepper? Should I use cutlery? All those kind of questions who will not hear. So now, because of the automotive aspect, you can use robot. If you cannot, you will use also interaction. But everything who can be done by a robot doesn't mean that humans will be forgotten. It will be much more about the experiences that you're going to offer to the customers. Clémence was saying about the data. She will tell you much more about what we're going to expect about the new technology.
So it's basically for the new technology, it's important for you to use that in every part of your work. So we'll see, we have listed everything related to blockchain, supply chain. These are typically two sectors which have evolved a lot in our industry as well. For the new technology, we have, for instance, hotels which are entirely run by robots at the moment, which that's what was Lucy was saying. And same thing for basically any kind of job that you will have in this industry, but also in others. You need to take into account the data. You need to take into account everything related to high tech, basically, because it's about making your life easier and making your job quicker as well. While keeping in mind always the customer in this field. For instance, we have wineries who are not able to sell wine directly to their customers. They imagine tons of things to be able to reach them in another way, and that was only through virtual reality and through the use of new technology.
And Clémence also was saying, and this is something that we really, really want you to understand. You're the future generation. You're the one creative, innovating. So instead of being afraid because you are inside of a path, a sector who's knowing that the COVID is very hard on you, on this sector, think of it as an opportunity. You have the time right now to think of innovation, of partnership with people from IT, from engineering, and creating new objects. Remember, now we are talking about the Internet of Things. So your knowledge of operational knowledge of the industry plus the expertise of one of your friends who are into engineering or IT can be something that you should do. But we cannot also forget the old good profession, like here you are, the profession that you know. So human resources, sales manager, accounting, everything related to the F&B, the concierge, travel manager, luxury, journalism, PR. So these are still very, very important part. But we will want it today to tell you that they are over career, they are over opportunity, and we'll be here to tell you about it, to discuss it, to discuss your project, but keep dreaming. For the requirement, very quickly, because I think that we're going to soon pass the time to be able to talk with you. So the requirement, it's very easy. We're helping the students through the visa, through the apartment, research, through the internship research. So we have a dedicated office to everything. So when you're coming to Vatel Bordeaux, you will not be on your own. So this is important also because you're coming to a foreign country. Mm-hmm. Now, how to apply? Clémence.
I was going to take the word. So to apply, we will need to receive the classic documents, your transcript, your last diploma, and obviously your letter of motivation. Then you will go through an interview and some entrance tests. The most important thing is really the interview, because we're going to check your project. And as we said before, we don't want to just hear, I want to do an MBA or I want to find a job. Well, we guess so, because otherwise you would not be here. It's really about you and why you want to choose this program and not one other. So it's really an exchange to see if we are the good fit for you and if we are the good fit for us. For the MBA applicant, there are like a little tiny thing before, which is the foundation year or some preparatory class. It's only for those who do not have already a background in hospitality. In any case, we will see when we receive all your application, we will see in where we can fit you, basically. And if you want to take courses in French, we will require a test which validates a B2 or C1 level. C1 is better for the MBA because there are more specific classes like law and accounting. But basically, for the ones who want to study in English, we do not require any test. Unless we become aware that we can't understand you during the admission interview. But otherwise, no test for us.
So thank you for listening to our presentation. Again, it's a very short one. So if you have a particular project, if you are thinking about a career path, remember it's very important for you to meet us and to come and discuss. Ask for the interview. Ask for meeting us in a private, in chat. Why? Because we are here for you, especially at the beginning of the year like that for us. Remember that the application for the scholarship may, the deadline may be in November, in December. So use this time when you're doing nothing home because the course haven't started, because you are more free to reach us, to ask us for information. Even if you're not coming to our school, it will be a good experience for you to chat with and have different prospects. So use this time to be able to contact with us. We've giving you our private email during the chat. We will return to the booth so you will be able to ask us questions. If not, you can reach us directly through the website Vatel Bordeaux or at admission@bordeaux. Thank you. At vatel.fr. So yes, I'm losing my words. It was lovely to meet you, and we're expecting you to see you soon. And I hope that we will be able to give you some advice about the wine industry. But really, really, come and visit. It's always lovely to be able to see the students. And we will have love to be able to meet you in person. So please come and chat with us.
Yeah, and above all, don't limit yourself to anything. It's just you need to try. Otherwise, you will never know.
And keep dreaming. It's important. Never say, oh, I don't have the experience, or I'm not enough good, or I don't have the quality, the skills. Everything can be learned. Remember, it's the human interaction who is important. So believe in yourself, and after that, you will find a way. So thank you very much for following us, and see you soon at the booth. Bye-bye.
Bye, everyone.